Hey, what's up? This is St. Joe, soundsofgear.com, here with the montage. I'm going to show you how to set it up as a DAW remote control for Logic Pro. Let's check it out. All right, so I got the montage set up with Logic. I actually just purchased Logic a couple days ago. Most of you know I'm mainly a Windows guy, but I've always kept a Mac around just for testing and stuff like that. But in this upstairs setup, it's kind of a more pared down setup. I'm using a Mac Mini. So I just installed Logic and I'm messing around with that, and Yamaha sent out the white Montage 6 so I could check out the 3.0 update, you know, with the pattern sequencing and stuff like that. But I figured I might as well try to set this up as a control surface for Logic so it makes it a little bit easier for me to navigate around and stuff like that. So what you want to do if you haven't set it up before, on the Montage there's a little icon on the performance page that says remote, which will get you to the remote settings. Also, you can do a shift, I think, shift and button 7 over here. Takes you to the same page. So this part, I didn't do any customization. But the main thing for me when I was trying to set this up, I didn't see any videos or anything on it, so I wanted to do one. But if you go over here to the settings, you'll see the settings in there right there. Mine says Cubase, but if I go over here and put it on Logic Pro, we're good to go, and you can see the pages. So you can control track, plug-in, and transport, and it kind of shows you what it controls. And you can turn on local if you don't want to play the keys. If you don't want the keys to play the sounds and you just want it to send MIDI, you can do that. And then you got the cursor and the dial and stuff like that. So I'm just using it really basic. So that's the thing you have to do on the Montage. But then inside of Logic, you have to go to preferences. First, you want to go to MIDI. And make sure under MIDI, under the inputs, you see these right here. Montage ports 1, 2, and 3. That is the USB ports for the Montage. And port 2 is the port that controls the DAW. Port 1 is like for your key input and stuff like that. So just make sure you have that. And then you want to go to Control Surfaces right here. And come to Setup. So if I go to Setup, I want to add a new one. So I click New and Install. And this is the one you want to choose right here, Mackie Control. It's already chosen because I set it up previously. But if you're at the start at the top, just come down to Mackie Designs, Mackie Control. Don't use Huey or any of the other ones. Use Mackie Control. Click Add. We can close that. And the main thing that you want to do is choose port 2 for your input and your output. And now what's cool and what is beneficial for me as somebody new to Logic is, you guys know I like hands-on control. Well, this actually gives me hands-on control over Logic, so I can actually stop, start, play. And I can actually even control the levels. So if you see levels moving over there, I can control pan. And these over here, so the top one selects your tracks, the top row, and then the next row is mute, so mute for your tracks. The next one is solo, so you can solo the tracks, and the bottom one is record enable, so whichever tracks you want to record enable, you can do that. And that's pretty much it. Like I said, you can go in and set up different custom CCs and, you know, set up more of the knobs and everything like that, but for me, this is really straightforward and gives me, you know, tactile control, tactile transport, faders, knobs over here. I think these down here you can set up for your function buttons, so F1 through F8 in the controller settings inside Logic. But yeah, really straightforward. And for me, I also have it hooked up via USB so I can stream audio into Logic. And so I just hop in and out. Like when I want to go back and pick sounds, I do that. And then when I want to go back to controlling it, I do that. And I leave local on so that I can actually play. I can actually play my sounds while it's in controller mode, and it lets me record tracks in and everything like that. So yeah, really straightforward. Like I said, for those of you that are Logic users and, you know, you've been setting up control surfaces and stuff like that all the time, pretty sure this isn't news to you. But for me, as somebody who's new to Logic, as a Windows guy, you know, this is a learning experience for me, just learning how to set up control surfaces and stuff like that. So I wanted to share it with you guys. So far, like I said, I've had Logic maybe a couple days, and I actually, the Montage, I think they actually came in around the same day, actually a couple days ago. So I figured I'd try to use them together. But yeah. Thank you. So yeah, it works. And for me, as somebody who likes hands-on control, this is a really cool setup. Really straightforward. Also, make sure that you download the Steinberg USB driver off of the Yamaha website. They say that you need that. I didn't need it to set up the audio. It automatically recognized it as an audio device. And maybe I'll do another video just showing how that setup works, or, you know, just how the audio shows up if you guys are interested. But they say you need a driver for this to work. So for the DAW remote function to work. But it's really straightforward. Really just works. I haven't had any glitches with it so far, and I wanted to share it with you guys. So, of course, if you got questions, let me know. This is St. Joe, soundsofgear.com. Also, if you're looking for plugins, presets, NKS packs, tutorials, courses, and all that types of good stuff, stop by the Sounds of Gear shop. I definitely appreciate the support. It definitely helps me continue to do the things that I do. So, like I said, if you got any questions, advice, tips, anything for Logic, montage, integration, anything you want to see, just let me know and I'll be exploring it. So, till next time, I'll see y'all later. Peace.